have your memorial lesson, nor where to start. But we do know that the oldest minutes we have of Sacred Harp singing include a memorial lesson. And in old days, 1930s, they would designate a particular amount of time for each state president, 15 minutes for Alabama, 15 minutes for this state and that state. And that's the way it is. And if it's a 3 or 4 day convention, they do some states one day and other states another day. They got all the states covered. The memorial lesson has no rule book. There's nothing that says, when you do a memorial lesson, you should do A, B, C, and D, or A, B, and F. So it's up to the committee that's called upon to do this to decide what to do. I don't know of any other group, or social club, or organization that does this. False names every week. Last year. I did have a humorous exchange with a lady one day after I gave her memorial lesson and made that statement. She said, I want to talk to you, and I've got a bone to pick with you, because we have in our church a day every year when we remember the folks that died in the last year. I said, you know what? We do that in our church, too. It's called All Saints Day. And we had 44 names on the list last year. But we only do it once a year. Saint Park folks do it every year. She said, well, I guess you got it. Today we're remembering singers from many places. Some of them sang for many, many years, some of them sang for just a few. We were all singers. I've never participated in a lesson exactly like this, where we are singing and talking about a specific member of this congregation, of this community. It's very appropriate. It's very fun to do that. We have a lot of singers to talk about for many states. Some sang for years. Some knew the pieces by heart. Others, like many of us, have to look at the book most of the time. When we don't look at the book, we sing some new choruses. Some brought down to the ground. Some are strong leaders. Some are more comfortable just sitting and singing. That's what makes the fabric of our community so wonderful. One we'll mention is was involved in TBC schools in these states, in and out of this country. One was very instrumental in revising a book and keeping the Sacred Harp community growing, planted seeds all over the country. Another goes hundreds of miles on the weekends to sing. And he had drive back home on Sunday night and post a little thing on Facebook, said, I got home at 2:30. And someone told us recently his car had 322,000 miles. Really? One traveled overseas often and helped singing get established in Poland and other places. They all contributed. We love them all. We don't separate singers into groups. We don't say this one liked this color book, and this one liked this color book, and this one liked this seven note book. We don't care what they sang from, what they wrote. We are just happy that they were Sacred Harp singers. I'm going to read the names of all the deceased singers first. And then we'll read the obituary first. From Alabama, we have Eloise Wooten, Daphne Cosby, and Johnny Taylor. In California, Nita Morix, Donna Andrews, Theodore Knott, Jim Van Wiener. In Georgia, Hugh McGraw, and Louise Howard. In Illinois, Berkeley Moore. Indiana, Daryl Smurdens. Minnesota, Charles Wells. New Mexico, Mark Collins. New York, Herbert Erickson. Oregon, California, Steve Helden. Texas, Katie Gorford, Edith Owen, Peter Nichols, Glenn Wendell, Robert Dennison, Julia Welch, Frank Price, and Preston Carter. From Washington, Isaac Engel. From Wisconsin, Julie Fia. What can you say about Edith Owen? What can't you say about Edith? What a loving life.
Take the kids.
73 years. Lived in the same house for 69 years. I've been living in 69 houses. Grandmother was 7, great-grandmother was 16, great-great-grandmother was 1. Remember this church? 71 chitties. That's astounding to me. We can talk about her love, her giving spirit, her deep faith, her smile, and the joy of her family. At the memorial service, Jeff said, "I don't care who your grandmother is, my grandmother could cook the best biscuits of anyone." Nobody disagrees. And Beverly, in her comments, talked about her favorite phrase about get in this house. Somebody would drive up in the yard, or she'd say, "Get in this house, sit down and talk with us." I know each of her children and in-laws. Our favorite stories of Edith, and they can tell those for years to come. As we singers have memories that grow, we're honored to have known her and to have loved her. And maybe during this noon hour, we can tell Edith's stories as we have lunch. Edith P. Marlow, Owen, November 17, 1919 to August 19, 2017. Edith P. Marlow Owen lived a long life in which she had a positive impact on many people whose lives she touched. Edith was born on November 17, 1919 in DeWitt County, Texas, in the Stratton community, Albert and Susie Alexander Marlow. She passed from this life on August 19, 2017 in Parkview Nursing Home. When Edith was 6 years old, her family moved to the Rio Grande Valley where her dad farmed, and they resided in the community of Sebastian. Edith attended high school at Lyford, where she graduated as valedictorian. And I'm sure she told her grandchildren that. If I can do that, you can. She attended Texas A&I College in Kingsville for 1 year. During that year, her younger brother Marcus drowned in a swimming accident. At the end of the school year, she moved back home to help support the family during the devastating time. She was then employed as a secretary to the Winkle family in Los Fresnos for the next 6 years. She met Curtis Owen of McMahon, Texas, Caldwell County, at a permanent Baptist church meeting, and they courted over the next several years, mainly by mail. You know, young folks, those were envelopes. During World War II, in which Curtis served in the Army of the Atlantic in Europe. In December 1944, he came home on furlough and traveled to the Rio Grande Valley and proposed to Edith. They were married 3 days later, and on December 13, 1944. They were married nearly 73 years. Two great things happened to Curtis on that fateful trip. He married Edith Marlow, and he missed the desperate fighting and the Battle of the Bulge. They had a quick honeymoon in New York before Curtis shipped out again to Europe, where he served until the end of the war in May 1945. After Curtis returned home, they settled in the Owen Farm and Ranch in McMahon, Texas. They lived in the same house, expanded and renovated several times for 69 years, until they moved to assisted living in Lockhart. They had their share of hard times. During their early marriage, Edith was a full partner. With the farm work, helping pick cotton, fresh peanuts, and delivering and selling eggs. She shared her savings from her single years to help Curtis buy land to expand the farm at a whopping $35 an acre. She was a member of Bethel Primitive Baptist Church, land for 71 years. She loved to sing Sacred Heart music and had a beautiful voice. Many young altos learned to sing sitting next to her. After she retired and Curtis semi-retired, they enjoyed traveling with Curtis' brother Leland to church meetings, singings, and visiting relatives while sightseeing over much of the United States. Edith was blessed with the gift of hospitality and loved having company. She was an excellent hostess and cook, and will be remembered especially for her green grape cobblers, cowboy breakfast, orange pies, and strawberry cakes. Her pride and joy was her family, who will miss her beyond words, but we rejoice that she is now released from her sufferings of this world and is enjoying the unspeakable joys of being in the very presence of the Lord. Edith is survived by her husband of nearly 73 years, Curtis Owen, and Sister Pauline Eagleston of Boston. Daughters Diane Ross, husband Donald of Plano, Beverly Coates, husband Bruce of McMahon, and son Tom and wife Mary Ann of McMahon. Seven grandchildren, Ryan and Owen Ross, Jeff Owen, Sarah Coates Huckabee, Amanda Owen Bowles, Reed Coates, and Holly Coates Evans. They also have 16 grandchildren and one great granddaughter. What a lovely, lovely life. It was a blessing to the world. And now her family is going to come and sing a song for us. And then Owen is going to have a prayer and business.